Hey, what's up? This is Cody the Coin Raptor. Welcome to my show. I'm here to talk to you today about crypto chart TA, and we're starting with Bitcoin. All right, Bitcoin has had several moves over the past couple of days. Yesterday, I was busy, so I wasn't really able to follow the charts as closely as I normally am. However, today, I've come in and I've drawn in a couple of important lines here for both resistance and support for Bitcoin. Our first, we have our support line here at 19,472, or about 19,500. That's the current level of support that it's been sitting at. Now, this level of support has shown to be somewhat strong over the past couple of days. We'll see if this holds or not, but I have a feeling it's going to have a difficult time trying to hold this support level. Now, if we actually zoom out and we take a look here at this descending triangle pattern right now that Bitcoin has made in the past, let's say, 2 months or so, it seems pretty clear to me that Bitcoin is probably going to go and retest this 19,500 support, and it might actually break through, just like we saw here in September. I think it's very possible that it breaks through that level and actually comes down here and retests support at 18,500. Also, very important is the RSI, and this really is what's holding Bitcoin back right now from being able to push out of these bearish formations, is the RSI, okay, the relative strength index, is preventing any sort of Bitcoin breakout right now. We can see here that with RSI, there is a strong resistance point here at 61, all right? Now, for RSI, pushing above 70 is basically considered overbought, and below 30 is considered oversold. Now, oftentimes when you see crypto or stocks or anything make a run up, like for instance, I'm going to demonstrate here with Ethereum, you'll see it push through this level here, so above that 70 point, and you can see that in order to push through resistance, you have to have the correct volume. And Bitcoin has not even been able to push through this resistance here for RSI. Now, as long as this resistance point holds, I expect that Bitcoin is going to keep falling, okay? Because other people are looking at these charts and they're noticing the fact that there is a strong point here in which Bitcoin comes up and it touches it, and then it immediately gives back all the gains, okay? This is symptomatic here of the broader bear market, but as long as this trend continues and as long as it keeps getting rejected at about 61, 62, Bitcoin is not looking very positive. It's looking bearish as long as it cannot break out through this resistance point. All right. Now we'll go ahead and take a look at Ethereum. Ethereum is now in this downward channel that I've outlined here. It's in this downwards channel. It's come up. It tried to break out of 2000. It was failed. It was rejected. And then we talked about there possibly being a head and shoulders pattern here where you have one shoulder, and then the head right here. And in that case, for a head and shoulders pattern, what you're going to see is you're going to see it return back to what they call the neckline. And the neckline is going to be, it's going to be about here or so in this region. Most likely, it's either going to be down here or it could potentially be right where it is right now. Either way, I think that Ethereum's got some room left to fall. I think that it's probably going to come back down here, and I've outlined this channel. It's probably going to come back down to this point here in this channel, about 1300 in this region. But we'll see what happens over the weekend. I've proven in one of my previous videos that the weekends are for selling. However, that being said, it doesn't necessarily mean that every single weekend has to sell off. So we'll see what happens with this weekend. We need to get some positive volume pushing in here and actually in order to push the prices any higher. And that just hasn't happened. There hasn't been as much demand for Bitcoin or Ethereum in the past couple of days. The macroeconomic picture has been very bleak. And on top of that, there has been a widespread fear, uncertainty, and doubt spread through media and social networks. So it's been depressing the price of Bitcoin and Ethereum. I also want to go ahead and take a look at the Bitcoin dominance chart. Bitcoin dominance chart right now is kind of showing what we've seen in the past here, where there is this resistance level that was a previous support level at about 41%, 41.5. It's now stuck within this channel of this resistance level, 41.5, and then down here to 38, 39 or so. Now with Bitcoin dominance, it's going to be really important to see whether or not Bitcoin dominance can rebound from just absolutely getting hammered over the past couple of months. It's just been hammered. I mean, it's gone down again. It went and revisited this point of about 39%, and this is a point that it made like all the way back in 2018. And so Bitcoin dominance not looking too hot right now. Ethereum dominance also not looking particularly good. We have almost like the double top pattern going on for Ethereum dominance, and it's shown time and time again that when it pulls up into this resistance box, it gets rejected soundly. And right now it looks like it's on its way back down again. There is strong support right here, but it's looking like it's pushing right through that support level. And if it does, then we're coming way back. We're coming all the way back down here to the June levels of where Ethereum was before. And again, that's Ethereum dominance. Now, Ethereum price can move independently of dominance, but if you're bullish on Ethereum and you think that Ethereum can flip Bitcoin sometime in the future, it's gonna have to push through these levels. There's no way that Ethereum flips Bitcoin without making a strong run and past this resistance box. And when that happens, if it does happen, I'll be sure to let you guys know. Follow me on Twitter for the latest updates. Now we're going to also take a look at the dollar index. Dollar index has been strong. There has been no signs of resistance whatsoever for the dollar index, and I expect that it's going to keep pushing. Next week, we have the Fed, and the Fed is going to be raising interest rates yet again, and that's going to add fuel to the fire here for the dollar index. So I expect this to keep moving up and keep providing downward pressure on the Bitcoin price. If we take a look at the Bitcoin funding rate, we'll see right now, we have patches of red and patches of green, alternating red, green for the past couple of days. And so what this means is that you have buyers and sellers, you have shorts and long positions both vying for dominance right now with Bitcoin. And you've seen the price move really sideways. So the market's not heavily weighted in favor of longs or heavily weighted right now in favor of shorts for Bitcoin. That's something I'll also be keeping an eye on. Now, you may think that it's been mostly doom and gloom this month, but actually the Bitcoin returns for the month of September really aren't that bad. It's actually less it's less than 1% negative right now for September. Now, we're not through September just yet. We have a couple more weeks to go for September, and we will check and see how this factors in, because as I've said before multiple times on this channel, September is often the worst time for stocks, the worst time for Bitcoin, and the average negative for September, the average negative, the average loss for Bitcoin has been about, let's say 8%, somewhere around that range, and we're not even at 1% yet. So if this plays out the way it normally does, then we could be seeing some more downside for the month. And this all comes despite the fact that Bitcoin miners have been selling, and they've been selling heavily. We checked the miner reserve on CryptoQuant, and the miner reserve shows us how much Bitcoin is in the miners' wallets. And right now, if we zoom out a little bit, we can see how far depressed this has gone. So miners right now, they're minting Bitcoin and they're selling it instantly right now, and they're providing some additional selling pressure on the price. All right. If we take a look at the net unrealized profit loss, which I did a whole video on, right now the total market for Bitcoin is in an 8% loss. Okay, so you can check this on CryptoQuant as well. CryptoQuant does have it a little bit more up to date. So if you guys are curious, you can always come over here. You can get this measurement free. However, there's still that 1 or 2 day lag or so. All right, so that's all I've got for you guys today. If you like this content, please let me know. Like, subscribe, comment. I greatly appreciate it. This is Cody the Coin Raptor, signing out.